Okay, so first things first, you will be needing a camera. The best lens you can use for this job is probably a macro lens or just your default kit lens, a manual flash with a bounce card. You also need a cable to connect your camera to your laptop or PC, the camera software of course, and your negatives. Go ahead and put your negative onto the flash bounce card. Use your live view and your camera software to check if your negative is sharp. For the best results, you have to put your camera into manual mode. Set the white balance to flash. Set your shutter speed to 1/125th. Set your aperture to f8 and your ISO to 100. Once the negative is sharp, you can take the pictures. Repeat this for every negative you have, and once you have them all done, you can go ahead and open up Photoshop. Okay, so here we are in Photoshop. Go ahead and open your image, drag it in there. First thing we do is we crop the image. So press C or go to the toolbar and select the crop tool. Crop the negative. Something like this. Enter. Fit to screen. And next thing we have to do is invert it because it's a negative. We do this by going to Image, Adjustments, then press Invert, or you can press Ctrl plus I. Short. First thing we notice is the image is really blue. We can correct this by going to Image, Adjustments and Levels, or for short Ctrl plus L. Next thing we do is adjust the channels so the image colors look natural. Let's go into red. Shift around a bit, go to green, just play with the sliders so it begins to look natural. Let's have a look at blue. As you can see, this is a lot better. Just play around with the sliders and see what looks best for you. I think it's kind of cool like this. Press OK. And there you have it. Your picture. What I also like to do is, the picture isn't really sharp. If you want it to be a little bit sharper, you can go to Filter, Sharpen and Unsharp Mask. This will give it a little bit of a sharp edge in the contrasts. Don't give it too much because it will look ugly. Something like this. You can see it makes the picture a bit sharper. And that's about it. Now you can save your picture somewhere you want it. And presto! That's all we needed. If you have any questions, comment below. And of course, subscribe for more future tutorials. See ya!